الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له اشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام ان الله كان عليكم رقيبا ما بعد فان اصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الامور محدثاتها كل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار. ان شاء الله tonight will be the lecture. Following lecture in the series of Dar al-Akhirah, or the series of the hereafter, and that is the coming of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the coming of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Ard al-Mahshar. But before that, just to make a little comment about some of the behavior and some of the things that some of the brothers try to do in Salah. And that is the issue of you trying to move back so you can allow someone else to take your spot in the more front line. As it seems to be a good behavior. But actually it's not the sunnah. You are so sweet that you want your brother to be in front of you. Usually you are standing in the first line and then you see someone you think more respectful, someone older, whatever reason you that makes you decide to move back and give him your spot. Or let's say Jumu'ah and it's time for Salah and the lines are established and then there's a place or a spot in the line in front of you and two people start inviting each other. It's very important that we understand the etiquette and what is the hukum and the ruling in Islam about these things. Usually ithar, and that is to put someone in front of you and ahead of you in general, or to give a believer a preference over yourself, is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encourages. قال الله تعالى ويؤثرون على أنفسهم ولو كان بهم خصاصة. Allah described the Ansar, and thus those the believers that need to follow Ansar, He said, and they prefer others over themselves. The way they received the Muhajirin, the way they took care of the immigrants, Allah described them, they prefer them over themselves. Even though, and may they might be in need for that money, or for that food, or for that place, yet they still prefer their brothers over themselves. That is a great attitude. And that is something Islam encourages. And the Sahaba are the greatest example that exemplified such attitude. However, there are certain things, putting someone or preferring someone over yourself, sometimes it's haram. And sometimes it's makruh. And sometimes it's recommended. So we don't want to mix between these things, thinking in general everything, or every time I want to prefer someone or put someone to be in more rewarding position than myself, whereas I had that position before. We do not, and we should not think that it's always recommended. طيب. Now I will give you just in general very quick, when it's haram, when it's makruh, and when it's mustahab. That means sometimes it's haram, it's forbidden to do it. And sometimes some situations. This situation of the salah is not one of those. And sometimes it's makruh, meaning not recommended, disliked. And that is in the salah. And sometimes it's recommended. Recommended whenever you prefer someone in mubah. What that means? When you give someone preference, and he thought, and give him something that you might in need, but something that you are permitted to use. Now when we say something mubah, that means it's not sunnah and it's not wajib. Mubah, some in general. Mubah is eating. Eating is mubah, is something permissible. So when you have food and you decide, you see your brother hungry, and you say, you know, I want this food, I desire this food, and you know what, I'm going to give it to him. I have some money, I'm going to give it to him, because he needs it. This is recommended. Why? Because the food is mubah. To eat is mubah. In the things that are sunnah, in the sunnah, you know, the Prophet ﷺ said, the best lines for the men are the front lines. That means the more ajr is in the front line. The more you are closer to the imam, the more ajr. It's the sunnah. No one says wajib and it's must, you pray in the first line. It's the sunnah. So in the sunnah, if you prefer someone over yourself, that is disliked. That is makruh. Meaning, if I'm already the first line established, and before we start praying, and then the second line started, and then I see someone of Ahl al-Fadl, someone that's respectful, a lot of us might, like you see the imam, or not the imam, whoever, someone in position behind you, so you back up and say, no, you pray in front of me. Or someone more knowledgeable, you pray in front of me. This is makruh. This is makruh. So you shouldn't do that. The third scenario is when it's haram. And that is, it's haram when the ithab in something mandatory. Meaning, you are about to do something that is obligatory upon you, but you decide, you know what? I'm going to prefer someone over myself. For example, you are two people, and it's time to make salah, it's time to make wudu, and you only have enough water for yourself. Okay? Of course, in this situation, you can make tayammum. But let's give another example, more concrete example. There, something happened, you got into an accident, whatever, you're traveling with someone, and someone stole your clothes, and there's only one garment. Alright? You need to pray with. So it's not, and time of salah is about to come up. It's not out of ithab for you to take off your garment so your brother prays in it and you stay naked. And you can pray. Of course, in such situation when they are close, you can pray naked. But it's not out of ithab because you're obligated to cover your own awrah before you cover other people's awrah. Yes, you, when you finish salah, you can give it to him and he can pray. He doesn't even have to wear it if he has no other choice. Or there is only few water left for your wudu. Alright? And then you say, you know what, I'm going to give you the water to make wudu, I make tayammum. This is haram. Because you're obligated to use the water. And you're not obligated to give it. That is not ithar. That is forbidden. So in general, when you do ithar in something mubah, permissible, that is what's recommended. When you do ithar in something sunnah, okay, that is makruh. And when you do ithar, and when I say ithar meaning prefer someone over yourself, when you do that in a wajib, something mandated upon you, that is haram. Got the picture? Tonight, inshallah, as I said, we will speak about, last time we spoke about the day of the shafa'ah and the intercession of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we said how people will go on the Day of Judgment and they're stuck in there. They're waiting. And they want the day of the accounting and they want the reckoning to start. And we said that people are drowning in their sweats based on their actions in this life. And we said that people under the sun is as far as an arm length. And this and that, and there is no shadow except for a group of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses. So a lot of stress and a lot of depression. And a lot of fear, and a lot of worries. So people want the reckoning to start and get over with, thinking that it will be done and will be over. They want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to start holding them accountable and judging them so they can be done. And we mentioned that the people will go to Adam alayhi salam. Then they will go to Nuh alayhi salam. Then they go to Ibrahim alayhi salam. Then to Isa alayhi salam, to Musa alayhi salam, and to Isa. And everyone has an excuse. And every one of those is worried about himself. And that's